9 hours ago to this moment, the day of reckoning that Pokemon fans across the world have been waiting for happened. It occurred suddenly, like a flash in the night. It was Pokemon Diamond and Pearl Remake. Yes, people have been looking for that really, really a lot. And they've been really latching onto a lot of rumor videos. Of course, every rumor video in the past having been fake. But this time, we had some much more, I suppose, stronger evidence to show that Diamond and Pearl remakes were actually coming. And this comes from website domains, or rather, subdomains in particular. So there's a lot of mess going on about here. Now, this is as far as we go, a rumor, okay? It's not proven, even though some websites, some Twitters have been saying it is confirmed. It's not confirmed. It's not. But we had this subdomain website right here, diamondpearl.pokemon.com, which now cannot be reached, okay? It was deactivated, but it was activated for a little bit, and it would have come up with a 304 error, or whatever error that is, when there is something there that you just cannot get onto. Sometimes it happens by accident for many of you guys who explore the internet anyway. If you have a little bit of a slower internet or something, you're trying to get into even Twitter or something, or Twitch, it might come up as like error 304 or whatever it is, and you will not be able to get in unless you refresh or something. It's just like a momentary lapse of internet connection. That sometimes happens. This page is different because they now, since, have taken it down. We do not get to see anything now. But up on when it was live, okay? But when it was live, guys, keep in mind, you weren't able to see anything. It was just the error, okay? But the fact that the error was there show that the website was made live. So for comparison, what we would have seen differently was if we were try to access different domains like these, which had no evidence of being activated at all, you would have gotten the same problem. These empty pages, all right? These are just empty. There's nothing here. However, at the same time, the other one, the Diamond and Pearl one, did show the error, which people, experts or whatever, are saying that had content on the website that just was not available. So it looks like maybe they tried to do something with the Diamond and Pearl website, whereas they didn't with these. But of course, with the hype being as high as it is with Diamond and Pearl, for some reason, people jump the gun and say, we can confirm. We can't confirm, we cannot confirm, and the reason that we cannot confirm is something I will get into a little later regarding Pokemon Sleep. Maybe some of you OGs remember this. But let's keep looking at some of the other things. The whole original thing started with actually PokeExperto showing us a ton of different domains that have been made live, at least live with the error, okay? And that included diamondpearl.pokemon.com, which it seems to match up with, say, what Sword and Shield might have been. If we go to the Sword Shield website right here, this is the Pokemon website subdomain swordshieldpokemon.com, okay? So that seems to be the layout, seems to seem legit, all right? Anyway, let's look at some other websites. We got legends.pokemon.com, but let's have a look at that one. Okay, so that one's also taken down. I think that may have been live with an error situation. But what's possible with all this, the fact that they went live in the first place with the error, what's possible out of all this is that Pokemon just procured the domains. Maybe they just bought the domains just now. And in the exchange of ownership, they were made live, they were checking the website or something, or they were removing the content that was previously on them or something like that. I'm no, you know, web expert or anything, but, you know, this is just possible how it works, because if we remember to Pokemon Sleep, something we covered a long time ago with Pokemon Sleep was that the website itself was purchased by Pokemon. But before that happened, when you clicked onto PokemonSleep.com, it brought you to this video right here, which is really odd. It's just Eric Whiteacre's song, some sort of song, which is odd, because actually we put in the domain PokemonSleep.com. He was just the old original holder before Pokemon got it. So that's possibly what the content that was disabled on those other websites, Diamond Pearl websites and all these new Pokemon websites, was changed to. It was just removed. That's possibly it, because they don't want to have that out in the open in case they do want to make plans around. Possible remakes were coming. But of course, it's just possible they wanted to buy it so that they don't use it. That's totally possible too. As you can see in the other things here, they got tons of test domains too. 25 OT test seems to be relevant to the 25th anniversary, of course. And then we got OneTrust test too. We got admin access skull.pokemon, okay? So yeah, this one is not really that visible, but you can see skull.pokemon.com here. Now, skull.pokemon.com is a good example as to why Diamond and Pearl Pokemon is not anything, okay? Let's do that. Let's try this. Pokemon.com. Skulled up. It's just another. Okay, can't be reached. Fair enough. Guys, there's nothing that's skulled up Pokemon.com. There's no website like that. They just obviously just grabbed a ton of little side websites that might be just useful. Hey, I wouldn't be surprised if later in the future we might see pearldiamond.pokemon.com. That's also a possibility. But either way, if there is a Diamond Pearl remake, we know one thing for sure. The Distortion World is going to go from this to this. At least everybody, younger generations and such, newcomers, will be happy. But if you're wondering what a Diamond and Pearl remake might actually look like, well, this is it. This is a fan creation on Unreal Engine of the first town and Route 201 in actual Diamond and Pearl and Platinum, okay? So it's just made with Unreal Engine. There's not really much in it or anything. But if Pokemon were to team up with some real game developers, this could be real. And guys, just a momentary reminder for if you like what we do here, do not forget to subscribe, because actually at the moment, about 60% of my viewers are not subbed. And I know Quiet Time was there for a while with Pokemon, but we still got so many good things coming. We got Pokemon giveaways, we got Shiny Celebi's jungle event situation on Sunday, that's gonna be given away, and we got a lot of Pokemon Unite stuff. I'm planning on getting into that big time. Speaking of Pokemon Unite, there have been some leaks for that just now. Today is the first day of the next beta in China, and some of the leaks have come out, but I gotta warn you guys, I'm not gonna be able to show you anything on the actual video, because that does get striked down, okay? But we can discuss what's going on. For example, a new addition to the roster that we didn't know before is Crustle. And we got pretty cute costumes. Machamp gets a flowery necklace. Lucario gets like a rogue outfit with a rogue hat as well. Cinderace gets a pirate hat. That's pretty cool. Greninja gets like this green space costume or something with a cape. It's pretty cute. It's cute as well. Mr. Mime gets a yellow sort of suit with a top hat. Talonflame gets a kind of farmer or peasant look from, say, England. And it's just a scarf here tied with a golden Pokeball and a sort of softball cap. I don't know how else to describe that. And Garchomp gets a scuba diving gear. This is pretty cute. Like, these things do kind of go along with some of the themes with some of these Pokemon. I think they fit really well. Wait until you see them, guys. I'd love to have shown them to you here, but I can't. I'm sorry. So guys, of course, this is a tweet that was deleted, I believe. Please hype responsibly. While we're 100% sure of our information, nothing has been announced, nothing has been confirmed officially. Don't mislead people. Now, I like to think that at least in my rumor videos and news videos, I don't mislead you guys. I tell you straight up the facts of what it could be and what it couldn't be or what it might not be, all right? And that's exactly what we did here with diamondpearl.pokemon.com, okay? We saw the comparisons to Pokemon Sleep. We saw the comparisons to all the other websites that were made live, which are definitely, some of them, not going to be something we can access ever in the future, such as the test websites, okay? That's just the reality of it, guys. It's possible this doesn't come. It's likely it does, because there's so much hype around and it's just been sustained for so long. Pokemon would be crazy and so out of touch not to tap into this opportunity. And once it does come, guys, I think everybody's just not gonna have anything to talk about after that for a long time. As for it being this year, well, we don't know, okay? We know there's a remake, mainline remake, coming in November at some point this year. What we don't know is what remake that is. I suspect that it could be, possibly, Gen 6 as well. I went through some evidence in the past, in some of my older videos, about the possibilities of that. It could very well, possibly, be Gen 4 again as well. Who knows, guys? We're just gonna have to wait and see. An announcement for that shouldn't be far off. We're expecting a Pokemon Direct in February, towards the end, with Pokemon Day, and we might get the first taste of news on that. That's gonna be huge, and I'm gonna be streaming it that day. And there's going to be a lot of people here, and I hope you are too. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'll see you around in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe so you can stay on top of all the latest news, and I'll see you then. Till then, bye.